So were you surprised that Tyson Fury kind of had that meltdown?
Yeah, because first he had just beaten Klitschko and beaten a heavyweight that was dominant over the last decade. I mean, he should have been riding high. This was his moment to capitalize. And, you know, we don't know what goes on in his personal life. We don't know what goes on behind the scenes. So, unfortunately for him, it all came to light. And hopefully for him moving forward, beyond boxing, getting his life in order first, and then the career second. But he's an entertaining guy, man. I definitely like watching him.
You know, after experiencing a low like that, you think he'll be able to bounce back?
I think so. You know, if he's able to get himself right, I think definitely he'll get himself back in the picture of the big fights. I mean, Tyson Fury is all personality in the sport. The sport needs guys like that, man. Guys with that are charismatic, kind of say whatever's on their mind, and you get a reaction out of people, good or bad. The sport needs people like that.
So I think this fight might have fell through. I'm not 100% sure, but there's a lot of talk about Klitschko and Anthony Joshua. Now, yeah. Anthony Joshua, kind of the young guy on the scene, but he's definitely a big problem. I mean, what do you think about that fight if that were to take place?
I would favor Klitschko. Not to say Joshua isn't capable of winning, because he is. I just think the experience factor would probably play out, but hey, anything's possible, and Joshua is a heck of a talent. He's big, he's fast, he's strong, Too bad the fight is probably not gonna happen next, but like I said, there's just there's a lot of interesting fights out there in the heavyweight division. The landscape is wide open, and it's gonna be fun to watch.
Another big one, Luis Ortiz and Malik Scott, man. I know a lot of people might be sleeping on Malik Scott, but I've heard, from fighters, nothing but good things about getting in work with him.
Malik's a heck of a guy, man. Malik's a real good dude. He's a real good boxer, slick as can be. And if people are going to go based off his performance with Wilder, I would think they're selling him short. Because Malik can, one thing he can do, man, he can box his ass off, man. That's one thing he can do. In a 6'5", 6'6", athletic boxer, he's going to give anybody trouble. Mm-hmm. Who knows what's going on with Luis Ortiz? He's older, he's had promotional issues, he's had, and hey, he's a heck of a fighter, though, too. So, it's a fight that I'm definitely going to glue to the TV.
So, can you kind of update us on your stable, man? What's next for you, aside from tonight, obviously?
I got tonight, Scott Alexander. I've got a whole host of young kids, man. I got a Joshua Collins, he's a 154-pound prospect. He's 14-1. I'm a co-trainer with Michael Love for his heavyweight, Alexander Flores. He's 15-1, good young Mexican heavyweight. Then I have a whole host of kids I'm turning pro, man, at the beginning of the year. Two solid 126-pound prospects. One is Jonah Flores. The other one is Anthony Chavez y Cifuentes, a national-level kid. I have a 152-pound national-level guy, Louis Lopez, I'm turning pro. So I've got quite a few guys I'm turning pro, and looking to see where I'm going to take them as far as promotion and